Everybody's watching her, but she's looking at you. Because you know I'm all about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, no trouble.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, teacher.
Okay, so how's everything with you guys? It's been a week we haven't seen.
Oh, it's great.
It's great. Mm-hmm. Rachel, yeah. How about you?
Everything's good, except that I got a stomachache. Yeah.
Oh. Stomachache? Did you go to doctor?
No, not yet, but I'm thinking to go today.
Yes, you feel better. because it's a little dangerous, and avoid some spicy food. You should better avoid spicy food. All right, guys, so we're gonna do reading today, but before we read, this is about treadmill. You know, by the time the industrial revolution started in the other countries, especially US or UK, those areas, they encourage the children and women to work in that area, you know. But in fact, this is not with a good mind. This is not with a good mind, because children and women are more cheaper than men. That's why they would like, they hire them. And the children has to work, you know, like a lot, long hours, okay? So, and this is the machine that what I show you right now is a machine about the what Richard Arkwright invented. And this machine is called water frame, and it can support lots of things to spin or to, in order to run the machine, we need water power, and this is the water frame to spin or to run the other machines. So please, let's see this short video clip, and then you will a little more realize how does it work.
For centuries, people had used the turning force of water wheels to help with tough jobs, like driving blades for sawing wood, and rotating coarse stones for grinding grain into flour. But eventually, water wheels began to power more complicated devices that would revolutionize cloth making, like this carding machine. What an improvement over the pet brushes. And by rolling out wispy slivers all day long, it was a great labor-saving device. But this was even better. I'm standing next to a machine called a water frame. It was created by the famous English inventor Richard Arkwright. This model's from the 1780s, to spin cotton into yarn. Though it looks fairly complex, it really isn't. It runs on water power, just like the carding machine and saw blades we saw earlier. The cotton in the top spools is drawn out by the action of the machine, which twists it nice and tight, and then gathers the yarn onto these bottom spools. It works just like a hand spinning wheel. 96 of them, actually. So it's little wonder that spinning by machine would eventually make spinning by hand obsolete. In no time, spinning mills began springing up all over England.
The most important.
Okay. How's the electricity there? My place is like darker than before because it is cloudy. Today is cloudy and then no electricity.
Is my place sunny? Not cloudy.
Yes, I see you. There's like some sun rays or sunny light beside you. Yes, but in my place it's a little cloudy and a little rain before my class start. Okay, how many people have we got? Julia, Kakong on the margin. Kunama da. ထောက်လိုက်တော့ဒီချက်ပြီးရင်စစ်ပေးမယ်เนาะတန်းတဲ့သူတွေကဒီချက်စစ်ပေးပြွားနော်အဲ့ထဲမှာလေစွမ်းအားတဆိုးလာပြီလားမလားဒီကောက်ခန့်ထိုးထိုးနဲ့စွမ်းအားတဆိုးချက်ပြောတာရှိတာတော့ရေးထားတာတာတော့အစိုးကြီးကအင်္ဂလိပ်ကကောင်းလဲဆိုတော့ရေးထားတာအချင်းကြီးရယ်ဒါပေမဲ့ဘာဖြစ်လဲဆိုတော့အရှိမexercise ကိုပြန်မဖတ်ဘူးလားမသိ exercise တဲ့မှာ तू က point နေနဲ့ရေးခိုင်းတာအဲ့ဒါ point နေနဲ့ရေးပြရမှာနော်ဟိုသူ့မှာပါတဲ့ clue words တွေရှိရလေးစာခိုင်းတဲ့စကားလုံးစာထားတဲ့ဟာတွေကိုအဲဒီတော့ကအဓိက तू က the lesson က writing ကဘာလို့လုပ်ချင်တာလဲဆိုလို့ရှင်ချေတော့ passive ကိုမှအာ subject မှာပါတဲ့ passive မျိုးလေးအဲ့ဒီဟာနဲ့ပတ်သက်တဲ့ use of english ကို apply လုပ်စေချင်တာအဲ့တော့ကြောင့် तू ကပေးထားတဲ့ writing တွေကဘယ်လိုဖြစ်လဲဆိုလို့ရှင်ဒီမှာသူက clue words တွေတော့ပေးထားတယ်မှာ in the past terraces were used to grow တို့အဲ့လိုပုံစံမျိုးလေးတွေထည့်ရမှာနော်အဲ့ဒါလေးမထည့်ထားဘူးလို့ဒီချက်ထည့်နေအဲ့ဒါလေးတစ်ချက်ထည့်လိုက်လို့ရှင်တော့ပို့ပြီးတော့အဆင်ပြေသွားတယ်မယ်နော်ဒီအပေါ်မှာ idea အပေါ်မှာအခြေခံပြီးစဉ်းစားဆင်ပြေမယ်ဒီချက်တစ်ခါလေးကြောက်လို့ရှင်မေးခွန်းနေကိုအာရှင်းပြလိုက်တယ်ဆိုတော့ကအင်စာဘယ်လိုလုပ်ရမလဲဆိုတာသိအောင်တစ်ချက်ရဲ့ဒုတိယချက်ကဘာလဲဆိုတော့ဒီချက်တော့အကြောင်းဟိုဆောင်းမွဲကြီးဖြည့်တဲ့ခါကြောင်ဆောင်းမွဲဆိုတာကဟိုဒီတစ်ခုတော့ပြောရမှာပဲဆောင်းမွဲဆိုဖြည့်တဲ့ခါကြောင်လို့ရှိရင်ဒီမေးခွန်းက trick ဖြစ်နေတာဖြစ်ဘူးလားဟာလာပြီးရတဲ့ခါမှာချက်တော့မေးခွန်းကိုဟိုမေးခွန်းကိုဘယ်လိုပြောမလဲနားလည်ဖို့လိုတယ်ပေါ့နော်မေးခွန်းက analysis လုပ်တတ်ဖို့လိုတယ်မင်းတို့ EFL UA ပုံမှန် analysis ဖိုင်ကိုပုံမှန်လောက်ရအောင်မယ်ဟာလာဒီဟာအသေးစိတ်ဒီစာဘာလို့ဒါ writer ပြောတဲ့ view point အစားကျတို့ analysis လုပ်ရတာနေပါတယ်เนาะအဲ့တော့ဒီမှာတော့ကျတို့အဲ့လောက်မပါဘူးဒီမှာwriting ဆိုလို့ရှိရင် writing လုပ်ခိုင်းတာပဲရှိတယ်ဒါပေမဲ့ဒီချက်ကတော့မေးခွန်းနေကိုတေချာနားလည်စေချင်တယ်ဖတ်စေချင်တယ်ဘာလို့လဲဆိုတော့မေးခွန်းနေကိုတေချာနားလည်ပြီးတော့ဖတ်ပြီးတော့မှရေးတော့မှအဆင်ပြေလိမ့်မယ်နောက်ပိုင်းဆောင်းမွေးကြလို့ရှိရင်လေကိုကဆောင်းမွေးရောက်လို့ရှိရင်လေကိုကရရတာနဲ့ဘာလို့ဘုံမရလဲပေါ့မှတ်တည်ရပါဘာလို့လဲဆိုတော့မေးခွန်းကိုတေချာဖတ်လို့ပေါ့နော်အဲ့တော့အဲ့လိုမျိုးဖြစ်တတ်တယ်အဲ့တော့သတိထားပါကောက်ကောက်ကောက်ကောက်ကဒီချက်မစစ်ရသေးဘူးတော့ပြောလို့မရဘူးဟုတ
်တာတော့ကြမ်းပဲရည်ထား
ဒီချက်အင်စာပြီးတော့ပြောလိုက်တယ်ဒီအဲ့ဒီ glue words တွေချက်ပြောလိုက်တယ
်မေးပါ့ဟ
င်းကောင်းတယ်မေးပါ့နောက်ကမေးတတ်တယ်ဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဒီလိုတောက်လေးမှမထားလိုက်ပါတော့ဒီချက်လည်းမေးတတ်တယ်ဘာလို့ဆိုတော့ဒီချက်အတန်း၃တန်းဆိုပြောရတာတခါကြအဲ့တော့အရင်ရေးကြည့်ဟာလေးစောက်တယ်မှထားမှာAll right, so what have we done? Hmm. Let's go around. I need to do it like that.မြတ်စုမြတ်စု did you follow the lesson or did you watch some of the clips I mean video clips to catch up the lesson
I watch the recording sometimes
ဟိုမျက်စုမျက်စုကဘာလဲဘိုင်ဘယ်ကသမီးဘိုင်ဘယ်ကဒီထဲမှာတည်ရဘာလဲဆက်ပန်စမ်းဟဲ့မျက်စုထိုင်နေနော
် yeah
Okay. Now we're going to go to page number 64. Full stream ahead. Please turn on page number 64, your course book 9. So they will be reading in the at the end of the page, right? It's right about 1712, 1769, 1771, 1790. So I want you guys to read about the cotton mills and the Industrial Revolution on page number 64, just about 1712 and 1769, firstly. Okay. And so that's asking. Do you attend other school?
I have a language class and it teaches like biology, history, and social studies.
Oh, you teach?
They teach like biology, history, the basic math, and the social studies.
All right. Yeah, you did the homework for the first time, and then, like as long as I remember, I think you missed checkpoint part a lot, right?
Yeah, I did.
Okay, I worry because you missed checkpoint part a lot, and I worry if you didn't catch about the writing because that academic writing is a little difficult and challenging one, and it is so related to the second book. I mean, the second book you are about to learn after you guys, all of you guys are about to learn after this book was pretty difficult. Okay.
I write them in the class sometimes, but I just didn't get a chance to send it.
Yeah. Because I don't know if I told about that to you guys. General English and academic English are totally different. You know, we understand the basic, or we totally understand about what we are learning, but sometimes it goes with rules. At the time, if you didn't know the rules, and it will be all right because you know the marks team comes up with the rules. That's why. I just worry if you have time, and I recommend you to watch some of the video you missed, which I teach you guys about the creative writing and then descriptive writings, because we trained a lot at that book, because next book is a little harder than the first one.
I'll do that. Thank you.
You're very welcome. Oh, okay. So let's start with this time, Yuya. Okay, what was invented in by the year
1712? Palm water.
Of water
out of the coal mine.
Have you finished reading?
No. I'm just right here, like,
oh yeah, it's all right. Then you read ahead. Okay, you read it.
Oh,
yeah. Can you answer the same question?
This like stream engine.
Stream engine, great. Thank you. Okay. Yes, so have you read the passage about 1769?
I'm still reading your 69.
All right. So you have done 1712, right?
Yeah.
So who invented the steam engine?
Thomas Newcomen.
Yes, Thomas Newcomen. Great, thank you. Susan. Yes, Susan. So tell me the invention or the innovation of News Coleman. The innovation of News Coleman.
Sure, innovation mean?
Innovation mean we, you know, we don't invent it anymore, but we try to upgrade it.
Yes. So, right. They said like in 1769, like the James Watt, like did a more like news car yes, engines yes. and by yes. adding there.
Right? He upgraded the steam engine. And what things can we, for what things can we use that steam engine that he upgraded?
Consider.
Mm-hmm.
By adding consider, which prevent the strings from the escape.
Mm, yeah. So his innovation, right? He just innovate the Thomas. He just innovate Thomas Newcomen invention, and so after he upgrade those systems and the after he upgrade steam engine, where what area in what area we can use that one? Rachel.
Cotton mill.
Mm-hmm. Cotton mill. And we also use water. Palm water, no, yeah, cotton mill.
Palm water.
Yeah, palm water is the first thing that, you know, the first idea of Newcomen that he invent to pump the water. But later on, James innovated, and then we can use in some of the blazers, such as in the cotton mills. Great. So we're gonna read about Richard Arkwright, what we saw in the video clip. So it is on page number 65, 1771 and 1790. Please read about that one. Okay, draw a line, no? Cover by line, cover the draw. Cover by line, cover the draw. Nazaru nem lagi.
A facial name, a fatif na do duela.
Fatif na fishes, a fishan.
Oh,
Madu the me. A fishan got our sadi barima. They better are a little hungry project.
Yeah, 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 yes.
Ah, pay my letter. Huh? So, yeah. I'll be no money, my lady. No, I didn't tell you what, then I see the canal. Yeah.
Zuzu?
Zoom allow.
Chen, Zuzu, I'll be on one.
Don't be on one, I mean.
Well, I'll
be on one. I'll be on
one. I'll be on one.
Oh,
I do what is it?
Zuzu.
You can't look on all over your domain. Is your right to the explanation. Oh, you still want my explanation? Or you get it right now?
I get it.
You get it. Okay. And let's talk about 1771. Let's see. So, what did Richard Arkwright build?
Cotton spinning machine.
Okay, cotton spinning machine. Okay. What is the meaning of mill? Mill.
Yeah, page number below, let's say mill.
Yeah, page number 65, sorry. It's a mill, what I do. First book.
Mills got to train it to the adult.
Mill.
A building, like. Which is like rings or brush to the cloud.
Data. Ah, mail got my
Yeah, Is that a factory?
A small machine for crushing things into the powder.
Yes, yes. Yes, it's mill is, you know, used in many, many things, such as water mill. If we say water mill, it is the mill that they produce the electricity by water. And here, just mill is it refers to a small industry or a small factory. Okay, here is a factory. Okay, so who could work in Richard Arkwright Mill?
The women and
family.
Yes, just women?
Women and young children.
Okay.
Young children, but
actually, it was a large film. Yeah, young children. Okay. There is a listening. Okay. Now we're gonna listen to. It's on page number 65. Exercise for listening. Do you see? Listen, which aspect of the Industrial Revolution is the focus of the program? So you firstly, we're gonna listen to it and you have to choose the one, the aspect of the Industrial Revolution from those three options. And we're gonna listen again and we will complete the summary of the clue words in exercise 5. So we're gonna listen to an audio and this is intend to finish. Okay. You may read the clue words in order to catch up the audio. Firstly, you may read the words, what's in exercise 4 and what's in exercise 5. I would like to prepare for the listening. It's a audio number. What is the audio number? 13. It's loading. I don't know what happened. Okay, get it. Starting, right? I know.
Welcome to the History Program. Today we're talking to Professor Johnson.
The children who worked in the mills at the end of the 18th and the beginning of the 19th centuries. What was life like for these children?
It was hard. Children as young as 6 years old worked in the mills. They started at 6 a.m. and finished at about 7 in the evening, so they worked between 12 and 14 hours a day.
12 to 14 hours a day? That can't have been much fun for them. And how many children worked in the mills?
A lot. In some of Richard Arkwright's mills, for example, two-thirds of the people who worked there were children.
What about health and safety?
I'm afraid that wasn't important to the mill owners. Accidents were very common. Children lost hands and arms because they had to clean the machines while the machines were running. And the air was full of dust, which meant that chest and lung diseases were common.
How much did factory workers earn?
Very little. And factory owners preferred to employ women and children because they were cheaper than men.
It must have been a very hard life.
Yes, it was. And they were constantly watched while they worked. Money was taken from their wages if they talked or left the room without permission, or if they fell asleep while they were working.
Well, thank you for that, Professor Johnson. And we look forward to hearing more in next week's programme, when you're going to tell us about how conditions got better from the 19th.
Okay, we're going to listen again.
Track 14.
A
Yorkshire Childhood.
Track 13.
Welcome to the History Programme. Today we're talking to Professor Johnson about the children who worked in the mills at the end of the 18th and the beginning of the 19th centuries. What was life like for these children?
It was hard. Children as young as 6 years old worked in the mills. They started at 6 a.m. and finished at about 7 in the evening. So they worked between 12 and 14 hours a day.
12 to 14 hours a day? That can't have been much fun for them. And how many children worked in the mills?
A lot. In some of Richard Arkwright's mills, for example, two-thirds of the people who worked there were children.
What about health and safety?
I'm afraid that wasn't important to the mill owners. Accidents were very common. Children lost hands and arms because they had to clean the machines while the machines were running. And the air was full of dust, which meant that chest and lung diseases were common.
How much did factory workers earn?
Very little. And factory owners preferred to employ women and children because they were cheaper than men.
It must have been a very hard life.
Yes, it was. And they were constantly watched while they worked. Money was taken from their wages if they talked or left the room without permission, or if they fell asleep while they were working.
Well, thank you for that, Professor Johnson. And we look forward to hearing more in next week's programme, when you're going to tell us...
Okay. You guys all the answer?
Yes.
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. Nesu, are you all right? I guess you say yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So the first one. So what is the aspect of the industrial revolution? The aspect is in my point of view.
We have to choose 1, 2, 3, right?
Yes, of course. We
I
have
think
one,
number two.
Number
two.
Two.
Yeah.
All of you guys choose
two. Yeah. Condition for workers.
Yes, correct. Conditions for workers in the mills. Okay. So did you catch all the did you catch all the information to fill the summaries in exercise 5?
Mm-hmm.
All right, then let's go to the first. The first one is already filled. Children as young as 6 years old worked in the mills. Okay. This one, Kamizu, they walked from what to? They walked from, okay.
I didn't catch.
You didn't catch that part. Okay. Yes.
Sister.
Oh, yeah. Indra.
Huh?
Okay, so how about other people's answer?
Yeah, I also agree that 6 a.m. to the 7 p.m., but also like 12 to the 14th holiday.
Yeah. I really like between 12 to 14 hours a day. Okay.
But this also
according to the clue it gives, they walk from, so they would like to know the time interval, okay? So we have better write 6 a.m. to 7 p.m.
Okay.
Accent were very common, for example.
Yeah. So, you lost and scores.
You lost a lot of arms and hands.
So I do it here, honey. Okay. Accent were, yes, we may like it all, no? Accent were very common, for example.
No. Children's were
because we have to clean the machine.
Children
are cleaning the machine.
Yes. Yeah. Must do right. Arms like.
Arms and arms.
Arms and arms.
Hands. Why?
Why they are cleaning the machine?
Cleaning lonely, I say, my
over. Now we're gone. Okay, so accident. The factory workers suffer from chest and lung diseases because
the air are full of dirt. Dust.
Air? Okay, going to be air.
Full. No, full. I feel I love full.
Are full of, okay, full of
dirt.
The air.
Dust.
The air fulls of
dust. P-U-S-T, I think.
Yeah, no. Air is full of dark and dust.
P-U-S-T.
Dust and?
Only that one.
That's
big. Dark. So they become like a disease, lung disease.
I think the air was full of dust.
Was full of dust, yes. Can I teach you up? I don't know, today my name is one of two days. I want to be a pastor, maybe that's a pastor. Maybe you don't know. Factory owners offer to employ
women,
children, because
women, because they were cheaper than men.
No, not boy, men.
Okay, because they were cheaper.
Only women teacher, not children.
Oh, I only heard, I also heard children. Women and children.
I only heard women. Oh, okay.
Woman
I think
only
women, yeah. Women and
children.
Women and children,
Women and children are in Many was taken from their wages. Wages, what is wages?
Salary. The many arms by their employees.
The salary they get, right? Many were taken mean many were cut, right? Some money were cut from their salary because one day
without the permissions or the maybe fall asleep during their
sleep or
talk or
leave without permission.
Leave without permission.
Without permission.
Leave the meal. Okay.
Meal without permission or talk.
Abela.
Yeah, how did
you? Talk.
Or talk. Talk about it. Let's check the young talk about it. Really? Do about it. Okay, that's why I share the channel now. Happy or do this or not? Happy them, no? Just only 1 minute. Over 1 minute. What's wrong? They saw I do jay yet. What's low that I leave? Yeah.
Track 13.
Welcome to the History Program. Today we're talking to Professor Johnson about the children who worked in the mills at the end of the 18th and the beginning of the 19th centuries. What was life like for these children?
It was hard. Children as young as 6 years old worked in the mills. They started at 6 a.m. and finished at about 7 in the evening. So they worked between 12 and 14 hours a day.
12 to 14 hours a day? That can't have been much fun for them. And how many children worked in the mills?
A lot. In some of Richard Arkwright's mills, for example, two-thirds of the people who worked there were children.
What about health and safety?
I'm afraid that wasn't important to the mill owners. Accidents were very common. Children lost hands and arms because they had to clean the machines while the machines were running. And the air was full of dust, which meant that chest and lung diseases were common.
How much did factory workers earn?
Very little. And factory owners preferred
to
employ women and children because they were cheaper than men.
Okay, employ women and children.
Women
or children also, children by, no? Okay, so we have to catch up the last one too.
It must have been a very hard life.
Yes, it was. And they were constantly watched while they worked. Money was taken from their wages if they talked or left the room without permission, or if they fell asleep while they were working.
Yeah, you guys are right. So fell asleep or leave the maid without permission or talk. It was
very no talk.
Yeah.
No talk. That's why I didn't hide that one. But you know, they leave their room without permission.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, it was a tough one, right? It was a tough one, and this is the start of the Industrial Revolution. I think at that time the people think that machines are more important than men or life. You know, they like lots of people. I think this is the age where we have the World War II, right? This is the time, World War I or II. No, before World War I.
But holiday or she asked.
They don't have holiday. They get paid according to the day they get paid according to the day they work. They have no holidays. And I'm thinking about Yorkshire childhood. We're gonna learn about the children who talk about their life in that industry and then during the Industrial Revolution ages. Okay, so we're gonna read about that one later on. And we firstly go to the next invention of Canada Coolit. Before we go this one, we have something to fill the blanks. Use of English past perfect continuous tense. past perfect continuous tense. Oh, I will just teach you guys past perfect continuous tense tomorrow because I will come up with extra lessons. So firstly, for today, we will skip that part. We will skip that part and save it for tomorrow. We're gonna go to page number 66, Kenneth or Cool It. All right. All right, celebration of CCC still by out, no? All right, she has switched all out on that. Not change. Save the. So you guys read ahead of the first page. That's sorry, the first part, the first paragraph is. First paragraph, please.
This is 66, huh?
Yes, this is 6. Just read the first paragraph. Have you guys finished? Okay. The flight is finished.
Yes.
Tell the flash guard to there. Do I see you as a young man? Bye. Susan, the cool below. So that yam yan or speed it yam yam of your pina, right? They win out of the hula. She said to me, you come up with eyes at Rila.
Hot way, I said. Gee, dear, dear,
dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, dear, ทำไมเจนน่ะดูริก็โลเลยเปลี่ยนตะบี้มาดิเจไอ้ဥစ္စာတကူကိုအဲပြောမဆိုရင်တချို့ရတော့ဖြစ်တယ်သူကမဖြစ်ဘူးအဲ့ဥစ္စာတကူတစ်ချက်ပြန်ပြီးသင်ပေးမယ်ไอเดียကိုဘယ်လိုမျိုးထုတ်ရလဲပြောရဲ့ခါကြလို့ရှင်သူတို့ဘလို့ဘောင်ဒရီမှာရေးရလဲပေါ့နော်ဘာလို့ဆိုတော့သူတို့ဟိုဘောင်ဒရီဆိုတာသူတို့ကစီးမင်းစီကံတတ်မှတ်တာမျိုးမဟုတ်ဘဲနဲ့လीဒီစာပိုင်းတစ်ပတ်တော့ Okay, when you see the picture beside it, what is it, guys? What is it?
Pin. Preserving food. That was
starving food.
Yeah.
Can it or cool it?
That inside like this tank, which is like store the food in there.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it is a kind of a tin. A tin, or we can say a pen. We can store food and preserve it for a long time. So this is the technology they invent. It's been many years ago. Do you like development? Do you like tin food?
No.
Tin?
No.
Yes. Right. How many kinds of curry have you seen with the tin food? With the can?
A lot.
A lot.
a lot. Yes.
My favorite one is like beam, like beam curry. I don't know.
Beam, yes, beam. Beam curry, beef, pork. I don't see pork, in fact. I see beef. And I don't know about chicken. How about chicken? Oh, yeah, chicken, of course. Chicken curry. And bamboo shoot with, yes, bamboo shoot with pea. And what is it? I think this is because of my connection. Connection of the chatting abbey.
Kiwi,
we shall. Me at the Mijet Jala, Wally, UBS Netami chain.
เนี่ยมันดีคลาสสามเนี่ยมะล่ะอูใช่ถ้าสมมุติมะนี่ตัวมันน่ะญาเนี่ยมันน่ะที่ลงอ่ะมะล่ะเนี่ยนี่มาญาๆลงมาล่ะใช่ถ้าเนี่ยดิใส่หนองเป็ดไล่อ่ะดิอ้าไม่เชื่ออืมๆนี่ตะมี้รู้บักกะเปลี่ยนล่ะอูเชียนนี่เป็ดออกเปลี่ยนล่ะเดี๋ยวเดี๋ยวตะมี้รู้บักกะเปลี่ยนล่ะตะมี้รู้ไปเป๊ะอ๋อดิเชียติอ่ะตามอยู่เลยหอดะตามวยเปียวแล้วดิญูเรป้ายนี่อ่ะเปลี่ยนมีล่ะ
รู้ใช่เปล่าอ่านอตตะกงนอตตะกงอ่านอตตะกงส่วนเนาะดิเชลโลမျိုးเว้ยเต็มมีลาไล่มาไล่ใช่มั้ยเนาะลาไล่มาแล้วใช่ตาเนี่ยสุเมติอืมฮัลโหลตาวญุตโตปัดโหลลาบิตาวญุตโตปัดโหลลาบิยูยารัวละกระหม่อมกับอีเซอันยักขันนี่ยูยะเอ้าไม่เข้าเอโกขึ้นมาเฮียไม่เข้า
ที่เช่าเป็นอะไรที่เช่าเอาไว้แบบตะมีโนะนะตอนนี้เนี่ยป่ะหวาลิอ่ะที่เช่าช่วยพี่ตาแบบตะมีหวาลิที่เช่ามีซูซูอ่ะตะมีซูซูก็หัวบาเลยอะตั้งหัวไปตัวละหุล่ะเข้าใจเช่ยาวไว้โอเคโอเคอ่ะกูไม่แพ้นะดิไอดีเนี่ยอินเจไอดีไอดีอ๋อแต่ดิเซลีแดนล่ะมันติดอยู่เช่ตัวเอาไว้ยาวไว้
ฮัลโหลเอาไปเอาเช่ประมาณอันนั้นสมัยโอเวอร์ไปอ่ะดีละพ่นน่ะเอาล่ะดีละอีดีละล่ะไม่ดีอะไรพ่นอ่ะฮัลโหลแล้วตัวอันเตะกูเปล่าพี่เกรุเปียงน่ะเมล่าพ่นน่ะดีดีละมาแล้วเราจะทักพ่นสิอินจิเนียร์อะไรไอดีอินจิเนียร์เนี่ยไอดีอินจิเนียร์เนี่ยไอดีไอ้คู่อ่ะเตียนอ่ะ
อ๋อไอดีเนี่ยหมอเลยช่วยอ่ะดิพี่ดิช่วยไล่ไปดิดาช่วยดาไม่จ่ายอยู่นะคู่สมีนะคู่อินจิเนียร์เนี่ยไอทีโซบิในป้ายชื่ออ๋ออินจิเนียร์เป็ดตัวมาซุซุชินจ้ะอินจิเนียร์เนี่ยไซเนสซับเจสต์นี่เนี่ยป่ะเนาะตัวเนี่ยรีเลทีฟที่ได้ภาษาดิโพไปแล้วเตียนอ่ะก็อ๋อไอดีบายสู่ไอดีบายเนี่ยปะทะได้หาโพเตียนอ่ะอะไรไม่จ่าโพใช่มั้ยไม่จ่าโพไม่จ่าโพซุซุอ่ะไอดีเป็ดกูช่วยดีกว่า
ตัวอ่ะตัวจ๋าสอได้อ่ะดิอืมตัวตัวจ๋าตะเมียเราคอกไก่ไอเดียเนี่ยองค์สารเนี่ย
related มาผิดเองโน logic
ซินซาเองเนาะคอกไก่เนี่ยอ๋อเชื่อไอ้ตะเมียตะกาก็บีลงไล่ล่ะดิคือเว้ยมาตุยรู้อะล่ะคันวงจ๋าตั้วปูอืมคอกไก่เชื่อไอ้ดิก็ดิ
Tua language di kuai dia, aku tak mian. Tapi tu yang ada sesi bersih. Okay, so let's see about candy or Kool-Aid. So you guys don't like canned or tin food, right? So can you tell me in what or okay So in what area canned food are useful? Or when do we use canned food?
Cold weather.
Water? Mm-hmm.
Cold weather.
We don't want to go outside. At the time, we can just open the tin can, open the can, and then we can cook it, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Good. And
also, teacher, we also use like when we don't have the time to or space to grow their own food, so they easily.
Yes, they are easy. Yes.
Yeah.
And in fact, you know, I think you did. Is there anyone who love to make the adventure trip? I don't mean the adventure from the movies. I mean adventure trip, like trekking or hiking like that. Is there anyone
else who enjoy? No.
It's tiring.
I only enjoy like kind of the beach.
Relax. Relax and chill. So for those places like camping trip or camping mean not the very close one, okay, a little far one, camping trip or hiking or trekking where we cannot buy the food easily, these tin food are useful. All right, so where did the tin food start? I think you should better reach the second paragraph in order to know the history of the tin food. Please read the second paragraph.
They started from the 18,000 century.
Yeah, 18,000 or 1800?
1800.
So. Two zeros.
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna be 1800. If we say 18,000, we are not here now. 2000, right?
Yeah.
So you say 18,000. Maybe we are not. We are in the heaven.
Maybe hell.
Yeah, but I'm in heaven. I'm sure. Okay, 1800. Okay, so 1800 li mali asli ya ba lu thae da ma thae da ba sia ma
ma
thae okay ma bao jin na
khun
ne paw yo thae li bna khun ka ni bna khun ni cha au
bra 1800 to
1899 1800 ka ni bi yo ho 1900 ma yak phin ta ni thi bo no 1899 ya 1800 sem bai aro 1800 ke s li pawne tabor ara to khu ni de ma mye de s pawne number de ma s pawne so tu a range ka jo ma so lo Napoleon Bonaparte offered 12,000 France as the prize to anyone who could find a way of preserving food. Okay, who finds the way of preserving food? According to second passage, who found the way of preserving food?
Nicolas Appart.
Okay, Nicolas Appart.
What
does he do?
A chef in Paris.
Yes, he's a chef in Paris. And he got the prize.
Yeah.
Okay, then he found a way. So what is his way of keeping preserving food? What did he use to preserve food?
Glass bottle that had been the first thing. And avoiding water.
Okay, so glass bottles, and we have to boil in the water, right? We will seal the glass bottle, close, tightly, and seal it, and then we boil in the water. So this is the first technology they started to use. This is the first way they started to use to preserve food.
So they boil the glass bottle in the water and not...
Yeah, we need to boil it in the water.
Oh, okay.
Okay, let's read the third paragraph. Susan, how are you? 15?
15, yes. In this year, I will be 16 on November.
This November, it's been...
Yes.
Yeah, so it's how many months ago? July, August, September, or 4 months ago?
11.
So at the end of this class, right, you will be 16. It's a great age to attend ICCSC, of course.
Yep.
So same with Indra, right? Indra.
Indra is.
Yeah, Indra is February, I guess.
February. Yeah. Oh. Okay.
A year, yes.
Huh?
A year, yes.
Yeah. Do ya? Do ya, Ovela?
Yeah. Also.
Yeah. 15, basically.
15,
baby.
Baby. 那外卖过啊，这么多吗？
好了。算了。 算了
14, 算了 14了。
我的倒是累的。
I will be 15 in this
month. Oh, really?
Yes.
Happy birthday.
To you, what is the date?
11.
11, oh, it's closer. 11?
你站的。
Yes, I know that. Because that is the appointment I took with my dentist.
But my birthday is Monday.
Yeah. But for this year it is Saturday. Rachel,
yeah, Rachel, what? August 14 beam.
Oh.
Oh.
August 14, oh they know.
哎，阿叔，算了，哎，老板们啦，算了，你，算了，阿叔，阿叔，December，嗯，嗯。I remember everyone's birthday.
I see.
你这打，哇，December，那我打三阿比嘛，你这打三阿比嘛。嗯，打三阿比。刚看都都那打你啊，就要丢回来了，打打你啊。
不过不急，打的，我都不急了，不啦，俺俩都不急。哈，打的啷个的？你来就。打的就中不了的。呀，你来就行。呀。中哎，中天的。哦。第二嘛，苏丹几中不落来？苏丹。呀，有啊。哎呀，怎么样，几中？除了苏丹，苏丹哪里没挂了哦？苏丹弄不下都不会没啦，苏丹也，Andrew也，又不中间的呀。对呀。
对呀，有呀，对呀耶，嗯，下集都没啦。不，为啥不来玩？不要。为啥不来玩？不要。为啥不来玩？为啥不来玩？不来玩。好啦，为啥不来玩？我在这边呀，我比较。我爱弄你主意。爱弄你，爱弄你。我爱撸么来。哈哈哈。爱弄你玩多你家啦，爱弄你。
April. Sorry?
April.
April, you're gonna be 15?
16.
16. Oh,
that's one that
I'm here. That's a different thing. Oh, damn, you're too. Okay, so have you guys read paragraph 3?
Yep.
Okay, then so
This is talking the innovation of the Nicholas invention, right? So, who innovate? Who innovated his invention? Who upgraded his invention?
Peter Durant.
Yes.
Durant.
And production of air rights can become marketized. Okay, Dan, what is his invention? What does he do to preserve the food? What did he use? He used tin, right? He started to use tin. So I think this is a mother, or maybe we can say father, technology of tin food, right? They started to use tin at the time. For the first time, they just only use glass, but it is fragile. So he upgraded the invention, and he used tin. He started to use tin since that time.
Yes.
So that's the message that it is a popular food at that age. Our tin food are popular at the time.
Yeah. No, actually, because like it was like the expensive.
It is expensive. So popular among rich people.
Yes.
It is expensive. It is popular in rich people, right?
Yeah.
Well, it's not expensive that much.
Because mostly update things are more expensive.
Mm. So tin food was great demand to feed the growing urban population. Because of tin food, it's well preserved, and the urban population means the people who live in the town or big city. Usually people who live in big city are supposed to be the urban people, the people who live in urban area. So it is okay, or it is great to feed the urban population, because they cannot grow their stuff, they cannot grow the crops, their stuff. They are working in the industry, so it is popular food for them at the time. Let's read the last paragraph. It's raining cats and dogs in my place. How about yours?
No.
It's cloudy.
Is it just cloudy?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Only just a little.
Little. Okay. According to the last passage, so the food are refrigerated. So what kinds of, before this refrigerated ship appear, what did people use to cool to preserve the raw food?
Ice.
Raw meat or like that. Ice. Okay. Okay, so according to this last passage, the refrigerated ship preserves the meat and meat for how long?
It took the 98
days. The longer time it preserves by shipping. From one place to another, what is the longest time they can preserve?
98 days.
Yes. Is that my connection is all right?
Your connection is right, I guess, but like your voice is kind of like the
lower and because I'm shaking my body.
It's like,
That's the point.
Is that raining there?
Can you hear really?
And it was raining in your area.
Yeah, because of raining. It was like
raining like a lot.
What is that mean? My place is
very sunny. Your place is very sunny. Okay guys, so can you find the names of the following in the text from exercise 2? The leader of an army, an old kind of many, a French chef, a British inventor, a ship, a newspaper. Can you find the name of those items? Please do it. We will check the answer later.
All right. What is the name of the leader of an army in the past?
Napoleon Bonaparte.
Napoleon Bonaparte.
Bonaparte.
And two, an old kind of many.
Francis.
Francis.
Yes.
Francis. And a French shop.
Nicholas Apart.
A British inventor.
Peter Durand.
Huh?
Peter Durand.
Yes. And a ship.
London.
Name of the ship.
London.
The name of the ship is?
It's almost like the first we begin.
You guys forgot the power. Yeah. You guys forgot the power of definite clause, indefinite clause. Make me laugh.
To read in. Richard said that. To read in.
Yes, I think this is Junding, just Junding. And it's pronounced as Jun, right? Junding. So this is a refrigerated, the first refrigerated ship, okay? And a newspaper. What is the name of a newspaper?
The Times.
Yeah, the Times. Okay. Let's go to page number 67, exercise 3. Find the word in the dance which means blah, 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 1, 2, 6. We will check the answer later.
Eh, Suzu, sana tua zai mula.
Siu.
Ah, macam mana ni?
Eh. Tua zai mula tu, apa yang warna? Apa yang warna? Tiba di di kung dia lor. Meli, wah, tua zai mula tu itu so, tu cakap dia. Tu a Friday, Saturday, Sunday, kalau saya Saturday, Sunday lah. Friday baru, no? Saturday, Sunday tu tu nak kupiang dah ni tu mau. Ibu tu kupiang tu mau, nak kupiang tu lah. Ada Yudi saya orang bawa mesti awal dia.
Nani ye?
Ini orang nak susun ya, be di sini. Cepu.
Ini lah.
Ni apa ni ada mi?
Cepu.
Cepu, di sini.
Haha. Yeah. Oi. Ni yang ni terus jauh lah, ni apa? Okay, you got the answer? Shall we check the answer?
Yes, sure. Yeah.
Then... Sun. What is the word for the first one? Close so that nothing can get out. Close so that
you ask.
Get in or out.
Yeah, did you ask me or not? No, right.
So I asked you.
Oh.
Bobby Rolaja.
I'm asking you, what is the word for a clothes so that nothing can get in or out? It's on page number 67. We are doing exercise 3.
Ah, crap.
Okay.
Page number 67, no? Tadi siap yang lupa lah.
Page number 67, exercise 3-1. And close so that nothing can get in or out.
Sealed.
Yes, sealed. Great. Next one.
Yeah. Yeah, sealed got one. Mother.
Yeah, number 3 must seem whole. First one, just refrigerate.
Number 3 got close, normal. Sealed. One, sealed.
Three
are bad. Yeah.
我要把你打嘞。哇，refrigerate。refrigerate这个叫A,B,B,OK,它。I answered D, I, N, and B, T, N.
So, enclose so that nothing can get in or out. 这个爸妈别说路了没有，别问路了没有，二八六他。
Be
that. See. Ah, baby, dale.
生
产年了，
对，生产年了。你想，你 CEO 皮了没？哎 ，CEO 那弄他你吗？
呀。
哦。他差不样皮来的，不要不要来。
Yeah, and an EDP, so we
are. You can use it like that.
Yeah.
In fact, this is still. Still is correct.
Okay. How about three?
Three. Three at.
We also see.
Is there anybody else who has different answer from still for three? Yuya, baby, darling, Yuya. Three, still Bella.
Oh.
Oh, okay. You know? 几回啊？
目前最下边，最下。
Okay, number two, you got it, no? Number two are heat until bubbles and steam are produced.
Wild.
Yes, boils so many. Heat is a good as a boil, you know? Easy, right? But adjective, easy adjective. Close so that air cannot get in or out. Air, let alone me out, when let me out, get close so tight, about it.Airtight.Stand by machines.
Mechanized.
Made cold.
Refrigerated.
Yes, refrigerated layer, no?
Frozen, go yeah, frozen.
Niyama Gajaro, frozen yab, frozen yab.
Let it go.
Let it go. Carry by a ship. Oh, it's a good singer. A good carried by a ship.
Argo.
Transport.
Argo.
Argo.
I just like the transport.
Okay, so that's all for today.So for tomorrow, please, I want you guys to read page number 64, use of English about past perfect continuous tense. And if you can do exercise three is better, but if you don't want to, or if you don't understand the lesson, it's okay too. So your duty, your homework for today is to read the use of English about past perfect continuous tense and if you understand. When we see tomorrow, we're going to ask,I'm gonna ask you and we're gonna discuss about it. I will come up with a more very structure.
Okay.
Thank you very much for today, guys. See you tomorrow.
Bye, teacher.
Bye, teacher.
Bye.